we have cancelled the band display, we have cancelled the ships open to visitors and ships open to students. Basically, we didn't want these events to become COVID spreaders, but to maintain the sanctity of Navy Day, we are going to put few of our ships at anchorage. They are going to illuminate, and I am sure those who are walking on the RK beach, particularly on 5th and 4th and 5th, they are going to have a spectacular sight of our ships there on display with their illumination garland. And also we are going to do a bit by cleaning the RK, the beach front which is there on the RK beach, and also the Kalinga beach. We are again not putting too many, but we are going to put some, almost 300 to 400 naval personnel there. I'm not making it as a media activity there, but we are doing it as an honest activity to contribute for the cleanliness of the city. And also we have had quite a few blood donation camps, and we are continuing with that. We are reaching out to our Veer Naris. We have got some 130 plus of them. We are reaching out to them with a small hamper as our gesture. And we are also reaching out to our orphanages which are there in the city to support them. In fact, we have been supporting them during COVID, and as part of Navy Day, we are again going to reach out to them, and whatever support and help we can provide, we'll be very happy to do that. And aim is, and also through you, I would like to thank all the Vizagites for their faith in the Indian Navy, for their support to Indian Navy. And in fact, I always say the destiny of Vishakhapatnam and the destiny of Eastern Naval Command is intertwined. In fact, we both have progressed together, and as the city is progressing, Eastern Naval Command is also progressing, and we have a plan for more development. And I'm sure when that happens, city is also developing, will always complement each other. Finally, through you, I want to make a very important announcement, and that is, we were supposed to have Milan in the month of March earlier this year, but we had to cancel that last minute because of COVID. We had confirmed the participation from 41 countries, ships and delegates coming here, but that was cancelled because COVID came, and obviously we could not afford to have ships coming to harbour and having interaction. But we are now going to have Milan along with President's Review of Vishakhapatnam in the month of March 2022. So what will happen is, whatever Milan we were having in March 2020 will be now in March 2022. Along with that, we are also, there is a customary that during the tenure of president, once he reviews naval fleets, once in his tenure, during the tenure of current president, we could not have it, the president's review of the naval fleet. So this is being planned. We are waiting for a date confirmation from Honorable President's office. The moment we have that, I'll announce the date. But tentatively, we have planned this activity, this event, in the month of March 2022, wherein we'll have Milan. We expect, because now we got more time, we are all reaching out to the ship, to the countries, so that they can budget. And we expect much more wider participation this time in Milan. And once the Milan is over, and soon after that, we'll have review, wherein ships will be there from Eastern Naval Command, from Western Naval Command, from Southern Naval Command, and also ships who are coming to participate in Excise Milan, they will also join our ships in the review. And thereafter, they all are going to go out to sea and have a big excise out at sea. And again, mutual cooperation, interoperability, and mutual trust, cooperation, will have these kind of excise. And I'm sure this will be very, very beneficial for the regional Navy, and also it will be very, very beneficial for all like-minded navies, those who come take part and then exercise together. So once again, my greetings to all of you on the occasion of Navy Day 2020. Stay safe, stay happy. Jai Hind.